Let's see the second colligative property, elevation in the boiling point of pure solvent. So already we have discussed that pure solvent vapor pressure is always greater than vapor pressure of a solution containing a non-volatile solute. Already we have discussed it. Now let us compare the boiling points. Boiling point, how to define? Boiling point is nothing but it is the temperature at which vapor pressure of a liquid becomes equal to its atmospheric pressure. That means here each liquid is having certain vapor pressure at a certain temperature. But on heating, what happens? Its vapor pressure increases, and at certain temperature, it becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. That is called boiling point. Normal boiling point means vapor pressure must be equal to 1 atmosphere pressure. Standard boiling point means vapor pressure of a liquid must be equal to 1 bar pressure. Okay, now which will have more boiling point? Either pure solvent or pure solution containing non-volatile solute. See, for that it is a pure solvent, it is solution containing non-volatile solute. This is solution, this is pure solvent, closed beaker. Okay, so in this, see here, total surface area is covered by only solvent molecules here. But in solution, surface area of this liquid is covered by some solute particles also. Some solute molecules also occupy the surface. So where the rate of evaporation is more, let 1 atmosphere is the external pressure for both the cases. So on heating, when it is heated, it is also heated. What happens? To equalize 1 atmosphere, its vapor pressure is increased. On heating, vapor pressure of a liquid increases, we know that. So here vapor pressure increases, and at certain temperature, let it be T naught. At T naught, what happens? Its vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure. Then that state is called what? Boiling state. When the vapor pressure of a liquid becomes equal to atmospheric pressure, the liquid simply boils. Boiling means evaporation takes place throughout the bulk, whereas in the normal liquid, evaporation takes place from the surface only. But at a boiling point, evaporation takes place throughout the bulk. That is the difference between evaporation and boiling. So here, vapor pressure of liquid on heating increases and reaches 1 atmosphere at certain temperature. That temperature is nothing but boiling point. Let it be T naught. Suppose at boiling point, rate of evaporation, rate of condensation, let it be some 100 molecules per second. Rate of evaporation 100 molecules per second. Rate of condensation also 100 molecules per second. So at a boiling point, to equalize the vapor pressure of liquid to atmospheric pressure, what is the rate of evaporation and condensation? 100 molecules per second. Let assume that. Similarly, go to solution containing non-volatile solute. Here, there are some solute particles also over the surface of liquid. That's why here also on heating, its vapor pressure increases. Here also, what is the external pressure? 1 atmosphere. To reach the 1 atmosphere, it is to be heated. So here what happens? If you heat it up to T naught temperature, there will be no rate of evaporation and condensation 100. Why not 100? Because here only solvent, that is only escaping. But here over the surface, some solute particles are also there. So number of solvent particles per ml here decreases. Number of solvent molecules per ml decreases. That's why rate of evaporation decreases, rate of condensation also decreases. Suppose when the temperature is reached to T naught, there may be 80, rate of condensation 80, 80 molecules per second. Rate of condensation is also 80 molecules per second. So at the same temperature, their rate of evaporation and condensation are different. Why? There are different number of solvent molecules in the surface. Okay, so here 80 only. But to reach 1 atmosphere, it requires 20 more molecules to evaporate. At the same temperature in solvent, it has 80 molecules. Rate of evaporation is 100, rate of condensation is also 100. At a T0 degree centigrade temperature. But here, at T0 temperature, evaporating molecules 80, condensing molecules 80. That means still it does not reach, the vapor pressure of liquid does not reach the 1 atm. That's why it is to be heated some more. Why? Here only 80 molecules. If 100 molecules, it boils. But here only 80 molecules. To reach 100 molecules, heat some more time the liquid. Heat some more time. So when you heat some more time, that becomes TS, which is greater than T0. So at TS, it starts to boil. So when you reach the temperature TS, now it is 100. So rate of evaporation 100, rate of condensation 100. So now its vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. So vapor pressure to become equal to atmospheric pressure, how much temperature is required for this solution containing non-volatile solute? TS temperature. But for pure solvent, T0. So which is more? Which is more, TS or T0? Yes, TS is more than T0. That's why this TS minus T0 difference is called elevation in the boiling point. Elevation in the boiling point of solvent. So now how to define the elevation in the boiling point? How to define? The difference in the boiling point of boiling point of solution containing a non-volatile solute and boiling point of a pure solvent is called elevation in the boiling point. That means when you dissolve a non-volatile solute in a pure solvent, its vapor pressure decreases, but boiling point increases. So pure water and seawater will not have the same boiling point. Which will have higher? Yes, seawater will have higher boiling point than pure water. Pure water, we know that 100 degrees centigrade. But for seawater, more than 100. Why? In seawater, there are so many non-volatile solutes. Because of that, so many non-volatile solutes dissolved in pure water, seawater is having relatively higher boiling point than pure water. So, this difference between the boiling point of a solution containing non-volatile solute and boiling point of pure solvent is called elevation in the boiling point of solvent. Okay, this difference we frequently call it as delta TB. This difference is called what? Delta TB. Here B stands for boiling. What is TS? TS is the boiling point of solution containing a non-volatile solute, whereas T0 is a boiling point of pure solvent. Boiling point of pure solvent. Okay. Now, how is it related to mole fraction of solute? For that, let's see a derivation part. Okay. So, from a graph, we derive all this. Let us draw a graph between vapor pressure, that means pressure, and temperature. So along x-axis temperature, along y-axis vapor pressure of a liquid, that means a pure solvent solution. Let this axis be 1 atmosphere. This dotted line represents 1 atmosphere. So this is the pressure with 1 atmosphere. Okay. Now, let us take pure solvent. This is the graph for pure solvent. Next, this is the graph for solution 1. This is the graph for solution 2. Graph of pure solvent. This is for solution 1. Okay, this is for solution 2. We are preparing two solutions. One is a 0.1 molar glucose solution, other one is 0.2 molar glucose solution. See here, where the vapor pressures are more, in pure solvent vapor pressures are more. We know that. Why pure solvent is having more vapor pressure. Okay, this is solution 1, this is solution 2. Now from the graph, can you say solution between solution 1 and 2, which is more concentrated? Yes, solution 2 is the more concentrated solution. Why? In solution 2, there is more number of solute particles. If solute concentration in the solvent increases, in the surface area, number of solvent molecules decreases. As a result, rate of evaporation decreases, rate of condensation decreases, finally vapor pressure decreases. So this lower curve indicates high concentrated solution. So solution 2 is more concentrated, solution 1 is less concentrated, solvent is pure, it is pure solvent. So then the solutions, two solutions, solution 1 and 2, solvent is having higher vapor pressure. We know the reason. Now, see here, for each solvent or solution, what happens on heating, its vapor pressure increases, reaches 180 m. I know I told already, where the vapor pressure of a liquid becomes equal to atmospheric pressure is called what? Boiling point. So this is the boiling point of what? Solution 2. Let it be T2. What is T2? T2 is boiling point of solution 2. Similarly, it is T1. This is boiling point of what? Solution 1. Similarly, this is boiling point T0. Okay, T0 is the boiling point of pure solvent. Let these pressures, let it be some P0. This is vapor pressure of solution 1. This is vapor pressure of solution 2. Now, here there are two triangles. Let it be A, B, C. A, B, C. See here. This is one triangle, A, B, C. Similarly, triangle A. Already A, B, C we have taken. D and E. Okay. D and E. This is another triangle, A, D, E. So there are two triangles. What are they? ABC and ADE. Okay. So here let's see the relation among the temperatures first. T0, T1, T2. These are what? These are boiling points of pure solvent, solution 1 and solution 2 respectively. Now what is the relation among vapor pressure? See here, P0 is greater than P1. P1 is greater than P2. Similarly, T0 is less than, T2 is less than T2, T3, sorry, T1, T2. That means, see, P0 is more among the three vapor pressures, P0 is more. But among the three boiling points, T0 is less. That means, if any liquid is having more vapor pressure, its boiling point is less. That's why for pure solvent, vapor pressure is more, but boiling point is less. For more concentrated solution, vapor pressure is less, but boiling point is more. Okay, here two triangles we have. Triangle, what is that? ABC and triangle ADE. Triangle ABC and triangle ADE are similar triangles. Similar triangles. So we can use the concept. See here, what is that? Here AE by AC equals to AD by AB. Okay. AE by AC equals to AD by AB. This is for similar triangles, relation for similar triangles. So what is AE here? AE is nothing but P0 minus P1. What is AC? AC means this one, P0 minus P2. Okay. So what is AD? AD means this difference. This difference means T1 minus T0 by. What is AB? AB means T0, T2 minus T0. This P0 minus P1 is nothing but lowering of vapor pressure for the first solution. That's why let us take delta P1 for the first solution, lowering of vapor pressure. Similarly, P0 minus P2, it is lowering of vapor pressure for second solution, delta P2 equals to that side. T1 minus T0 means it is delta TB1. That means elevation in the boiling point of solution 1 by delta TB2. This is elevation in the boiling point of solution 2. So from this we can write that, from this we can write that delta P is directly proportional to delta TB. Okay, so lowering of vapor pressure of a solution containing non-volatile solute is directly proportional to the elevation in the boiling point. Okay, next, from this already we know that this delta P by P0 is equal to, we know that mole fraction of solute. Take P0 that side. Then delta P equals to P0 x2. That means delta P is directly proportional to mole fraction of solute. As delta P directly proportional to x2, you know, delta TB is also directly proportional to mole fraction of solute. You know, mole fraction of solute and molality, how are they related? Directly. So, mole fraction of solute and molality of solution, where M is molality of solution, they are directly. So from that we can write that delta TB is directly proportional to molality. Now if you remove the proportionality symbol, put is equal to symbol and some constant, that constant is nothing but KB. What is that? KB. So what are the terms in it? KB is called molal, molal elevation constant. Molal elevation constant. Where KB is molal elevation constant. Its value depends on the nature of solvent. KB value depends only on the nature of solvent. Similarly, M is molality of solution. Molality of solution containing non-volatile solute. KB value depends on which factors? KB depends on solvent. KB depends on solvent. What are the units of our KB? Units of KB. Units of KB are, from the formula we can derive the units. How? Delta TB, it is nothing but difference in temperature, so its value Kelvin. What are the units for molality? Mole per kg. Units of molality, mole per kg. So take this side, then you will have delta TB by M. Delta TB by M means Kelvin, kg, mole inverse. Okay, so these are the units of KB. How to define KB? We can define KB from the formula itself. If molality of the solution is taken as 1 m, 1 molal, then delta TB of that solution is called what? KB. So to define KB, molality should be 1. So what is the definition for KB? It is the elevation in the boiling point of a solution containing non-volatile solute in 1 molar solution. elevation in the boiling point of one molar solution containing a non-volatile solute is called KB. Okay, right. So units of KB, Kelvin, kg, mole inverse. KB value for water, KB value for water 0.52 Kelvin kg mole inverse. In some problems KB of water will not be given. That's why we have to remember this value 0.52 Kelvin kg mole inverse. This KB thermodynamically it is its value is find out. KB value is given as KB value thermodynamically determined, its value is R TB square by LV into 1000. This equals to R TB square into gram molecular weight 1 by enthalpy of vaporization into 1000. See the terms involved in it. What are R, TB, LV? R is nothing but gas constraint. You know that universal gas constraint. Okay. TB means it is boiling point of a pure solvent. Similarly, LV is latent heat of vaporization. Latent heat of vaporization. Similarly, latent heat of vaporization means enthalpy of vaporization by gram molecular weight 1. What is the difference between latent heat of vaporization and enthalpy of vaporization? This is enthalpy of vaporization. Can you differentiate them? What is the difference between LV and delta vap H naught? Latent heat of vaporization means it is the heat energy required for the conversion of one mole of substance. It is the energy, heat energy required for the conversion of one mole liquid into its vapor. Whereas enthalpy of vaporization means it is the heat energy required for the conversion of one mole of liquid into its vapor. That is enthalpy of vaporization. What is latent heat of vaporization? It is also similar. It is the heat energy required to convert 1 gram of liquid into its vapor. So this is energy for the conversion of one mole liquid into vapor, delta vap H naught. Whereas LV is, it is the energy required to convert 1 gram of liquid into its vapor. So for one mole, for 1 gram, that is the difference. Okay, using this formula, we can calculate the KB value. After calculation of KB value, we find out the elevation in the boiling point. Okay, this is all the information about elevation in the boiling point. Let's see how is it determined experimentally. You know, this delta TB is determined experimentally. Beckman's method. It is determined by the experimental method called Beckman's method, where Beckman's thermometer is used. Do you know the difference between this Beckman's thermometer and a normal thermometer? This Beckman's thermometer is highly accurate. It directly takes the elevation in the boiling point directly. When a solution is kept, it measures the direct value of elevation in the boiling point. It can give the temperature value more accurate, 0.00 something. So that a small value, small difference also it can measure. That is the advantage of Beckman's thermometer. Okay, so delta TB is determined experimentally by which method? Beckman's method. Next, how is it related to particle concentration, gram molecular weight of solute? Let's see some relations, sir. You know, delta TB is directly proportional to particle concentration, just like RLVP. It is also directly proportional to particle concentration. Similarly, delta TB means, yes, TS minus T naught. TS means it is the boiling point of solution containing non-volatile solute. T naught means boiling point of pure solvent. Okay, so this difference is directly proportional to particle. Then my question is, TS is how is related to particle concentration? Of course, TS minus T naught is directly proportional. What about TS? In TS minus T naught is a constant value because it is boiling point of pure solvent. So it is constant. Only variable term is TS. It is also directly proportional to particle concentration. TS is also directly proportional to particle concentration. Next, if weight of solute is same, then use the hint, delta TB is inversely proportional to gram molecular weight of solute, non-volatile solute. Here, if weight is constant, weight of solute is constant, then use this hint to compare the more and more or less delta TB. Which solution is having more value or which solution is having lesser delta TB, to compare use this hint when weight of solute is given. Similarly, what is boiling point relation? Boiling point also in the similar way. Okay, let's see some examples. First example, given that 0.1 molar some glucose, second one, 0.1 molar some NaCl, third one, 0.1 molar some magnesium chloride, fourth one, 0.1 molar some K3FeCN6. Now question is, which is having the highest elevation in the boiling point? So in that way, some questions will be asked. Four options will be given, which will have the highest delta TB or least delta TB or highest boiling point, least boiling point. In that way, a question will be given. Let's see how to answer such questions. Now these four options are given. Now question is, which is having the highest elevation in the boiling point? How boiling point, elevation in the boiling point and particle concentration related? Directly proportional. That means the solution with the highest particle concentration will have the highest elevation in the boiling point. Now calculate particle concentration for all. This is glucose. Glucose is a non-electrolyte. So solution concentration, particle concentration same. 0.1 molar. This is 0.1 molar NaCl. So here 0.2 molar particle concentration only I am writing in the brackets. It is 0.3. Why it is 0.3? 0.1 is solution concentration into particles given by the salt. Three particles. MgCl2 gives three particles. What are they? One magnesium ion, two chloride ions. That's why 0.1 into 3, 0.3. Similarly, K3FeCN6. It can give 3 potassium ions, 1 complex ion, total 4 ions. So 0.1 into 4, so 0.4, 0.4 molar. Now say, which is having the highest delta TB? Yes, this fourth option. Why? Particle concentration highest, that's why. Similarly, can you say the least boiling point among the four? Least boiling point means, see here, this is the boiling point of solution containing non-volatile solute. Boiling point of solution. Okay. So here it is also directly proportional to particle concentration. So the least boiling point is for first option. Why? Particle concentration here 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. Particle concentration is least for glucose. So delta TS or delta TB, delta TB, elevation in the boiling point and boiling point, both are directly proportional to particle concentration. Okay, so delta TB is highest for fourth option, boiling point of solution is least for first option. So in that way, we compare the boiling points or boiling point of solution or elevation in the boiling point of solution.